This is the class for the continuous sight lens. In the last exercise, miscellaneous exercise. Okay, so already you have completed all the exercises in 10th chapter. Exercise 10.1, 10.2, and 10.3. The students. Okay, let us move over to miscellaneous. So already you know what are the formulas we are using in the sight lens, deviation of sight lens, and what are the types, which means the m equal to infinity. So infinity means how to take students directly, you know, 0 divided by anything, I mean 0 divided by 1 or 1 by 0. 1 by 0 only operation. So m equal to 1 by 0. So already you know the value of m. So what is your slope? K minus b by 4 minus k square. Okay. Now we will substitute. So k minus b by 4 minus k square equal to 1 by 0. Now taking a cross multiplication for this, we get it by 4 minus k square is equal to 0. Okay, 4 minus k square is 1, 4 minus k square. So 0 into k minus is 0. Yes, student. Now, what are you going to get the value k? What is the k? Which is equal to k square equal to plus 4. Minus k square wants to move that thing. So k square is equal to plus 4. Then the value of k is equal to plus or minus 2. That's all. Yes, student. Now coming to the third question, what is that given? Passing to the origin. Origin is what? 0, 0. So what is your first equation? What is your given equation? So for that given equation, I am going to substitute x comma y equal to 0. Okay. The y because of it is passing to the origin only. So k minus 3 into 0 minus 4 minus k square into 0 plus what is that? K square minus 7k plus 6 equal to 0. So this two terms only tells 0. Why? Because of 0 and anything? 0. Okay. Now what is the remaining? K square minus 7k plus 6 equal to 0. Now I'm going to factorize like this to get here 6. Product is 6 and sum is minus 7. So what is your product will come? What are the factors of minus 6? Minus 6 and minus 1. Okay, 2 3 are 6 is not available. So minus 6 minus plus 1 6 are 6 minus 1 minus 6 equal to what is that? Minus 7. So k minus 1 into k minus 6 equal to 0. So finally I am getting the value of k 1 comma 6. The value of k is 1 comma 6. And next question, we want to move the question number. Question number 3, students, next one. So look at the question number 3. Okay. So for this BCAS, I give you that as per the model basis. Okay. We can move by the model basis also. So question number 3, lesson overview. Find the equation of the line which cut off the intercept on the axis whose sum and product are 1 and minus 6 respectively. Okay. So intercept means, I'll show you. See, first given we need to write sum and product of the intercept. Sum of the intercept, yeah, the sum is equal to what is that? 1 and product is minus this. Product is minus. Now we know very well what is the equation of straight line in intercept form. Equation of straight line. It is intercept form. What is your intercept form? X by A plus y by b which is equal to 1. Now you have a value sum of the intercept. Like a be the x intercept and b be the y intercept. So by the condition k, sum of the intercept a plus b equal to 1, ab which is equal to minus 6. Ab which is equal to minus 6. So take this equation, take the equation number 1. Now ab equal to minus 6, no, I need only b or a, nothing rubbish. Okay, suppose I need only a means, what will come? Minus 6 by b. Minus 6 by b. Okay, so this one I am going to substitute a plus b equal to 1. So a plus b equal to 1, we have a value a, that is minus 6 by b plus b equal to 1. So taking a cross multiplication, minus 6 plus 6b, what is that? B1, no, sorry, b square. B into b, b square by b which is equal to 1. Which is equal to 1. Now taking a cross multiplication, plus B want to move that side, it will come minus B and minus A. Now, I am going to factorize like this, minus 6 is minus 1. So, what will be the factors of 6? 2, 3 is 6, huh? Okay. Now, 2, 3 is 6, I am going to give you a bigger number than 3 sign to get on both also negative. So, you have value of B is B plus 2 into B minus 3 equal to 0. Finally, I am writing the value of B is minus 2 comma minus 3. Minus 2 comma minus 3. Now, you got it that value of B, shall we go and complete that value of A? Okay. And A equal to, you have a value of minus 6 by B. So, when B equal to minus B, minus 2, B equal to minus 2 means A equal to minus 6 by minus 2, minus minus cancel, so A equal to plus 3. Okay, and B equal to plus 3 means A equal to minus 6 by 2, which is equal to what will come? 6 by 3, which is equal to A is minus 2. Minus 2. Finally, we are taking the values of A 2 values and B also 2 values. Now, I am going to substitute the equation number 1, x by a plus y by b equal to 1 to get the equation of sine line. Yes, student? Okay. Now, take first, a equal to 3 and b equal to minus 2. Then, a equal to minus 2, b equal to 3. Yes? Okay. Now, x by a, that is x by 3 plus y by minus 2 equal to 1. So, taking a constant division 2 into x and 2x, plus 2 minus minus 1 becoming minus 3y by 6 equal to 1. So, 2x minus 3y equal to 6. This is your answer. Let's take all the things in one side, that is 2x minus 3y minus 6 equal to 0. That is your answer. Okay, and next, again, x by minus 2, x by a is x by minus 2, plus y by b which is equal to 1. Now taking a cross multiplication to get 3x minus 2y by minus 6 equal to 1. And minus is going to move that side, divide into that side this multiplication. So 3x minus 2y equal to minus 6. So this is your final answer. Okay, if you want to take it one side, you get it by 3x minus y plus 6 equal to 0. Okay, now the condition is, and next question you want to move. Yes, students, next question number 4. Now listen carefully, what are the points on the y axis whose distance from the line x by 3 plus y by 4 equal to 1 is 4 units? Okay, now see, given you have a line x by 3 plus y by 4 is equal to 1 and distance d equal to 4 units. Okay, now what is the equation asking to you? What are the points on the y-axis? What are the points on the y-axis? So first, this one is x by 3 plus y by 4 equal to 1. This is the intercept form. Now taking a general form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Yes? Now solution 4 into x 4x plus 3 into y 3y by 12 equal to 1. Then finally 4x plus 3y equal to 12. 4x plus 3y equal to 12. Shall I take all the terms in one side? To get 4x plus 3y minus 12 equal to 0. So this is your required general form of equation. Now the distance is given. Okay, so its distance is 4 units. No, from which point we have to consider by 0 comma actually. Why? Because of the question is, what are the points on the y-axis? On the y-axis. So on the y-axis means it contains y coordinate only. It will not come in that x coordinate. So I'm consider 0 comma y be the point on the line. This line equation number. On the line equation number 1. Now if you have a formula d equal to, what is that? modal sum of A x1 plus B y1 plus C whole divided by square root of A square plus B square. So this is a distance formula, no? So from the distance formula, we should find the point 0, y. 0, y. So this is the point on the y-axis. On the y-axis. Now I'm going to substitute. That is, what is the value of B is given? 4. Okay. So 4 is equal to, you have an equation. 4 is equation of straight line. 4x plus 3y minus y equal to 0. So for that, A equal to 4, B equal to 3, and C equal to minus 12. Minus 12. Have you got each other? Now what I'm going to do? See, 4 is equal to A into x1. And x1 is 0, y1 is y. X1 is 0, y1 is y. So A into 0 means 4 in AX1, that is 4 into 0 plus BY. BY1 is B. 3 into y1 is y plus C is minus 12 whole divided by square root of A square is 4 square plus B square is 3 square. Okay, so here I'm going to cancel the models. Okay, to get what? And because I'm going to simplify this, see. Shall I take left to right like this? Okay, 4 into 0, 0, so 3y minus 12. 3y minus 12, whole divided by 12. 4 square is 16 and 3 square is 9. So 16 plus 9, which is equal to 4. Which is equal to 4. Now 3y minus 12 whole divided by 5, which is equal to 4. This, first I am going to cancel the models to get that side plus or minus. Already you know what is your meaning of models. Models mean when you are over substitute this any and a non-negative or negative value inside the model symbol, we are going to get that positive value. Yes, student. Okay. Now 3y minus 12 by 5, which is equal to plus or minus. Now my divide to find out to move, that's it, become multiplication. So 3y minus 12 equal to plus or minus 20. So 3y equal to 20 plus 12. See, minus 12 moving, that's it, plus 12, na? So 12 plus or minus 20. So 3y equal to 12 plus 20, comma 3y equal to 12 minus 20. So 3y equal to what is that? 20 plus 12, 32. Okay, and here 3y equal to what is that? Minus 8. Minus 8. Okay, now finally, y is equal to 32 by 3. First. And the second one is y equal to minus 8 by 3. So finally, we got it that two values of what? Y. Two values of y. So that's what is the given question. What they ask in the question? What are the points of the y axis? Okay, so that's the required points of the required points are, what are they? 0, 32 by 3 and 0, minus 8 by 3. Now, what is it? Shall we move the next one? Number 6. Find the equation of the line parallel to y axis and drawn through the point of intersection of the line x minus 7y plus 5 equal to 0 and 3x plus y equal to 0. Okay, 6th question. First, give a hint. Parallel to y axis and minus 3x.
minus n.
So this one I'm going to simplify the equation number 1, y equal to minus 3x. So equation number 1, that is x minus 7 into minus 3x plus y equal to 0. Now x minus is minus plus 21x plus y equal to 0. So 21x plus x equal to what will come? 22x. So 22x which is equal to minus 5, then x equal to minus 5 by 22. X equal to minus 10, 5 by 22. Yes, now I am going to take the identity number 1 or y. This one I am taking as 3 part. Okay. Now take the identity number 3 to substitute the value of x. So y is equal to minus 3 into minus 5 by 22. So the value of y is minus 2 minus plus 5 is 14 divided by 22. Okay. Now the point of intersection is, point of intersection is what are they? Minus 5 by 22 comma 15 by 22. Minus 5 by 22 comma 15 by 22. And next, one thing is given, that is parallel to y axis. So shall we consider the, what is the value of slope? See, parallel to y axis, so the slope m equal to will come 1 by 0. 1 by 0, why? Because of not dependent. As in the previous question also we have done now. Okay. Now I have a slope and I have a point. When one slope and one point is given, we have an equation of sine line. Equation of sine line. Point slope formula, you know that. Y minus y1 which is equal to m into x minus x0. Okay, always y minus y0 equal to m into x minus x0. It's not a problem. Okay, so this is the point x1, y1 and this is the slope. Shall we take a substitution? Y minus y1 is 15 by 22 which is equal to m. That is 1 by 0 into x minus into minus plus 5 by 22. Minus is minus plus the mean part. Okay, so the divided by 0 is going to move that left side, it become multiplication. So 0 into y minus 15 by 22 which is equal to 1 into x and x plus 5 by 22. So this fully cancel part. So it is getting 0. Okay, now taking last multiplication to get 22 into x which is equal to 22x plus 5 by 22 equal to 0. Finally, this 22 I want to move that side, it become 22x plus 5 equal to 0. So this is your final required answer. So this one is an equation of sine line positive, I mean parallel to the y-axis and positive to the point of intersection from the two lines. X minus 7y plus 5 equal to 0 and 3x plus y equal to 0. So next question number 7, already have a same pattern of the fourth question. Okay, so try to answer. So you are homework today is question number 7. Okay, and next we want to move the question number 12 in the same pattern. I mean the same pattern means the point of intersection pattern. Okay, so I am giving you now the question number 12. So students, I am reading the question, listen carefully now. Question number 12. Find the equation of the line passing to the point of intersection of the line, that is 4x plus 3y minus 3 equal to 0. So take as equation number 1 and 3x minus, so 2x minus 3y plus 1 equal to 0. Yes, sorry, this one is changing. 4x plus 7y. Okay?
Yes.
So 4x plus 7y minus 3 equal to 0 and 2x minus 3y plus 1 equal to 0. So this two sidelines is given. So this one passing for passing to the point of intersection the above line and that has an equal intercept on the axis. Equal intercept on the axis. So first I am going to simplify the above two equations So you know the English word concept, yes, students. To get an, to form an, any one of the coefficient numerically equal. So I am considering now the coefficient of x. So the first equation I am taking is as per the same 4x plus 7y minus b equal to 0 is equal to 0. And next I want to take the second equation 2x minus 3y plus 1 equal to 0. So this one I am going to multiply by 2 to get 2 2's are 4x minus 6y. Then what is that? I am multiplying 2 now plus 2 equal to 0. Now the simple change minus plus minus 4x and 4x will be cancelled. Now 7 plus 6 is 13y minus 5 equal to 0. Minus 3 minus 3 equal to minus 5. So 13y minus 9 is equal to plus 5. Now y equal to 5 by 13. 5 by 13. Okay. Now taking the first equation to get the answer for x. Okay. To subtract the value of y. So 4x plus 7y. So 7 into 5 by 13 minus 3 equal to 0. Now 4x plus 35 by 13 minus 3 equal to 0. Now I'm going to take a mass multiplication to get 4x 35 minus 13 is 39. So minus 39 by 30, which is equal to 0. Okay, now the simplification 4x minus 4 by 13, which is equal to 0. So 4x equal to plus 4 by 13, minus 4 by 13 moving that side, plus 4 by 13. So 4 4 cancel, mean x equal to 1 by 13. 1 by 13. Now the point of intersection is, PT mean point of, okay. Point of intersection is 1 by 13 comma 5 by 13. 5 by 13. Now I find the value of my point of intersection and then I want to move by that equal intercept. Equal intercept. So equal intercept means C. You know the equation of right line in intercept forms?
Yes.
What is your equation of right line? X by A plus Y by B equal to 1. Now intercept and both also same, equal. Okay. So for that equal means you have to take A equal to B on both intercept also same. Okay. Now this one I'm taking equation number 3 from. Okay. So taking equation number 3 to get that x by A plus y by B also A. Why? Because of on both also we have a same answer. I mean equal magnitude. Equal length of the intercepts. Okay. Now the same denominator means x by y by a equal to 1. Okay. So x plus y is equal to a. This one will take equation number 4. And we have a point of intersection. It is 1 by 13 comma 5 by 13. Okay. Now 1 by 13 comma 5 by 13 forms us in equation number 4, above equation. Okay, now 1 by 13 plus 5 by 13, which is equal to 8. So directly we have to add with 1 plus 5 is 6. Now 6 by 13, which is equal to 8. So A equal to 6 by 13. Now I am going to substitute that equation number 4 to get the equation of sine line. So equation number 4, substitute A equal to 6 by 13 in equation number 4. Okay? Now x plus y equal to A. Huh? So x plus y is equal to 6 by 13. Okay? This divided 13 form to move that side become multiplication. So 13x plus 13y equal to 6. 13x plus 13y equal to 6. 6. So this is your final answer, no?
Yes.
If you want to take one same thing, that is logic. So this is your final answer. Okay. And the next question. So 10 syllables, 500 area of the pen. But one small difference, in your 10th syllabus, you prepare when the 3 vertices are given, we need to find the area of a triangle. But this one is given, is different man, like the 3 sides are given. Okay, now listen. Given, these 3 sides are, first one is y minus x equal to 0, take us equation number 1, then x plus y equal to 0, that is equation number 2, finally x minus k equal to 0, that is equation number 3. Okay, now I am going to solve this above equation. Solve this above equation. Okay, now I am going to give you the diagram. This is A, B, 3. So 3 vertices. Now I am going to take this one is y minus x equal to 0 and x plus y equal to 0, then x minus k equal to 0. X minus k equal to 0. Now the point of intersection of these two lines will be the point K, and point of intersection of these two lines will be the point of B, and these two lines will be the point of C point. Okay, got it? Now see the third equation. First I'm going to take to get x minus k equal to 0. So easily we know the value of x. Easily we know the value of x. Okay, now I'm going to solve the first two equations. Equation number 1 is y minus x equal to 0, and equation number 2 is y minus x, that is y plus x equal to 0. So that I have to take. It is not a problem. Hey student, why? Because we want to arrange only, no? Yes. Now the simplification, x and x cancel. So 2y equal to 0, then y equal to 0. Y equal to 0. Okay, so already we know the value of x. Okay, and now we know the value of y also. Hey student, so we have a point A, yes? The simplification of this two. This two only, no? Okay, so for that, B, so first B, the equation number 1, you have to take y equal to 0 means 0 minus x equal to 0, x equal to also 0. Minus x equal to 0, x also 0. So therefore the point B is 0, 0. And before that, x equal to k1. Okay, so we want to simplify this two to get the value of the point A. So the point A is x equal to k, so here also I am going to substitute. Okay, wait, x equal to k. Okay, now I am taking this first equation to substitute x equal to k. So y minus k equal to 0, y equal to k. So therefore the first point A is k comma k. So the first point A is k comma k, and second point B is 0 comma 0. Now the third point I am going to find to compare these two equations. First, I mean equation number 2 and equation number 3. So from the equation number 3, already we know the value of x equal to k. Value of x equal to k. So this one, I am going to substitute this place to get. What is that? Equation number 2 is x plus y equal to 0. So x you have k plus y equal to 0, y equal to minus k. Y equal to minus k. Now we are talking that the point C also k comma minus k. What is that? K comma minus k. Now what is the given question? Find the area of the triangle formed these points. Okay, now take the point A is k comma k. The point B is 0 comma 0. The point C is k comma minus k. Okay, now you have an area of triangle formula in your lower class. I will take the 1 by 2 into x1 into y2 minus y3. Can you remind? Plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Okay, now I am going to substitute the value to get 1 by 2 into this is x1 y1 and that is x2 y2 and this is x3 y3. Okay, to substitute now, x1 into k into y2 minus y3, so minus into minus 0 another plus k, okay, plus x2 0 into y3 minus 1, so minus k minus k, so 0 is anything, 0 only coming, okay, so just you have to substitute, plus x3 k into y1 minus y2, so k minus 0. Yes, students. Okay, now the simplification, 1 by 2 into k plus 0 plus k into k, so k into k is k square, okay, 1 by 2 into k square plus k square, so 1 by 2 into 2k square, 2 cancel means, what is the final answer? K square unit. So this is your area of a triangle. This is your area of a triangle. And next question. Question number 9. So that is also the same question. But one small difference, we need to find the value of P. Question number 9. Okay, children. Now, listen to you. Find the value of P. Show that the three lines are given. You find the three lines. What are the three lines? Tell me. So the first line is 3x plus y minus 2 equal to 0. So take as equation number 1. And second equation is px plus 2y minus 3 equal to 0. So that is your 2. The third equation is 2x minus y minus 3 equal to 0. So this is equation number 2. Okay? Now we need to find the value of E. Find the value of E. And before that we should know one thing. See, the three lines are intersect one point. Intersect one point. So the three this one concept you should know. So the three lines are intersects are meet at one point that they are called called concurrent line or concurrent line. Point of concurrency already know the yes. So the concurrent line. Okay, so for that it is very simple to check. You have three lines. So from the three lines, second line only you have unknown number. So first I am going to solve the equation number 1 and 2. Okay. So solve the equation number 1 and 3. Solve the equation number 1 and 3. Some of the value come to 1 point. So that point you want to substitute that answer. Equation number 2 to get the value of P. It is very simple concept only. Yes, student. Okay. Now see equation number 2. That first 1 I am going to take 3x plus y minus 2 equal to 0. And equation number 3 is 2x minus y minus 3 equal to 0. Okay. Now we don't want to change the symbols. That you have plus y and minus y cancel. Then 2 plus 3 5x minus 5 equal to 0. 5x equal to 5, x equal to 1. X equal to 1. Now we will substitute the equation number 1 in the value of x is 1 means 3 into 1 plus y minus 2 equal to 0. 1 3 is 3 plus y minus 2 equal to 0. So 3 minus 2 is 1. So y plus 1 equal to 0. The value of y is minus 1. Value of y is minus 1. Now the points of intersection. Point of intersection is 1 comma minus 1. Now the 1 comma minus 1 passes in 3. Sorry, 2. Passes in equation number 2 to get the value of P. So Px P into 1 plus 2 into minus 1 minus 3 equal to 0. Okay, so 1 into P minus 2 minus 3 equal to 0. So P minus 5 equal to 0. So the value of P is plus 5. So the value of P is plus 5. Okay, and the next question. And question number 14. now coming to the question number 14. So the two questions only we are going to see in this class, the last two questions. So question number 14. Okay. So in bond ratio, already you are done this kind of sums in your previous 10th syllabus by using the section formula. Okay. Now listen. In bond ratio, the line segment line joining the points A minus 1 comma plus 1 B is minus 1 comma plus 1 B 5 comma 7 B 5 comma 7 is divided by 9 is divided by the line x plus y equal to 4 divided by the line x plus y equal to 4. Okay, now listen, one line, this is P and this is A, this one is B, A and B. One line is divided, the ratio M is to N like this. Okay, now using section formula. Using section formula. Okay, using section formula, you have a formula. What is that? No. M x2 plus N x1 by M plus N, comma M y2 plus NY1 by M plus N. Yes, friend. In your previous 10th syllabus, you are using M and N instead of M1 and M2. M1, M2 only you are using. But here M and N are both also same only students. Okay, don't get any confusion. So this is your X1, Y1, and that is your X2, Y2. Now I'm going to substitute. M into X2 is 5. M into 5 plus N into X1 is minus 1 whole divided by M plus N. Comma, M into Y2 is Y2, 1 is 7 plus N into Y1 is 1 whole divided by M plus N. M plus N. Now I am going to multiply inside the bracket to get 5m, 5m minus n whole divided by m plus n, comma 7m plus n whole divided by m plus n. Okay, you have a line, divide by the line you have. So for that, here I am going to take x and this one is, this quadrant is y. I am going to substitute the equation number 1. One more student, x plus y equal to 4. So for that x value and y value you want to substitute to get the value of ratio. Okay, now x is 5m minus n by m plus n plus 7m plus n by m plus n, which is equal to 4. Now you have a same denominator, so 5m minus n plus 7m plus n whole divided by m plus n, which is equal to 4. Now the simplification, 5 plus 7 is 12m, and what is that? Plus n and minus n will be the cancel. Okay, now what will come? 5m by m plus n which is equal to 4, and 5m which is equal to 4m plus 4n, and plus 4m coming, that will be 5m minus 4m equal to 4n. Okay, now 1 minus 4 what should I get? What is that value? 8m which is equal to 4n. Now m by n which is equal to 4 by 8. Now m by n which is equal to 1 by 8. So the required ratio m is to n which is equal to 1 is to 2. What is your final answer? 1 is to 2. And the last question is that 1 is to 2 which is divided internally only. Okay. Externally is not. Okay. And the last question, is question number 15. Question number 15. So this is your last question in this class. Question number 15. So find the distance of the line of what are they? Two 5 equal to 0. So take up equation number 1 and 1 point along the line, that is 2x minus y equal to 0. That is equation number 2. And point is given, that is 1, 1 solution. We need to find the distance. So it is very simple, students. Listen, this is a line 4x plus 7y plus 5 equal to 0. And what point is that? That is 1, 2. And this line is 2x minus y equal to 0. So we need to find this distance. This distance d. Okay, students. Now I'm going to solve the above two equation to get. Take the equation number 1, this is saying 4x plus 7y plus 5 equal to 0. And equation number 2 multiply by 2 to get 4x minus 2y equal to 0. Now, sign change, minus plus, always moving that way. Minus by like this. Okay? Yeah. Now, want to change the symbol 4x, 4x cancel. So, 7 plus 2 is 9y, which is equal to minus 5. Now, the value of y is minus 5 by 9. So, the value of y is minus 5 by 9. Now, this 1, I am going to sum to the equation number 1 to get the value of x. Okay? Or 2, equation number 2 simply sum to 1. Okay? What is the equation number 2? 2x minus y equal to 0. So 2x minus into minus, what is that? Minus into minus plus 5 by 9 equal to 0. Okay, and next, I need only x. So 2x equal to minus 5 by 9. Minus 5 by 9. I need only x, that is minus 5 by 18. So therefore, the point of intersection is. What are they? X minus 5 by 18, comma y. What is that? Minus 5 by 9. So this is your point of intersection. Okay, now what is the given? What are they asking? Find the distance of the line, this two point intersecting line, intersecting point this, and one more point that. Now when the two points are given, we know this. What is the area? So first of the point is minus 5 by 18, comma minus 5 by 9, and the second point is 1, 2. 1, 2, you know? Yes. Now we have a formula, distance d equal to x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square. Now I'm going to substitute x1 is minus 5 by 18 minus x2 is 1 the whole square. Plus y1 is minus 5 by 9 minus y2 is minus the whole square. To simplify this, to get the distance, okay? Now taking a cross multiplication of this, minus 5 minus 18 by 18 the whole square plus minus 5 minus 18 by 9 the whole square. So this is some because number, so listen carefully all of you this. Okay, now you have a minus 23 by 18 the whole square plus square root of what is that? Minus 23 by 9 the whole square. So on both sides also you have a numerator by 23, no? Now we are taking outside to get 23 in the numerator and the denominator will take 9 the whole square. Okay, into what is your remaining? So the remaining comes of here 1 by 2 the whole square plus here 1 the whole square. Okay, shall we go to children? It is very easiest to you. So 23 by 9 I am taking outside. So the remaining square root of 1 by 4 plus 1, that is 23 by 9 into square root of 5 by 4. Square root of 5 by 4. If you want to take outside and to divide, that is 23 by 18 into root 5 root. Why? Because 4 only have a square root. Okay? Have you got it? So what is your distance? So the distance d equal to 23 by 18 root 5 units. Okay?
Yes,
now you have a formula. Question number 7T. Today homework is in exercise question number 7. And examples you have 20, the same question in the first one. 20 and then 25. So these two questions only. Okay? Yes, students, today class is going to complete now. So do the questions, all the questions practice well. Okay, we'll see you in the next class.